you so much, Mr. Vineet Jain, COO of V-Mart, for joining us. And we continue our focus on non-metros in this series presented by Dainik Bhaskar in association with Exchange for Media. And the topic today is Bharat Festive Cheer continues. As we have seen in the last 2 months, the spends have been back, and especially retailers have been aggressive with their spends. So, Mr. Jain, thank you so much for taking out time and joining us. My first question to you is that retail was a sector that was heavily impacted due to COVID. Not last year, this year, I would say, because it's a few days away from the next year. However, if you see, there was a significant uptick during the festive season, as you know. Tell me, how did the festive season play out for you, for V-Mart?
Sure, Royal. First of all, thank you very much for giving us this interaction opportunity. I can say, I think we, during this year 2020, we have seen the unprecedented time. Nobody imagined that this can happen in our life ever. Okay. And then starting, if I'm recalling my memory, like starting from the March end to April, May, we have seen the complete lockdown, then again moving to the May, June, July kind of, it's a partial lockdown, then some market open, some market close, some timing restrictions. So all kind of the permutation combinations of the market we have seen over the past. And September, October, I think the market was in a different phase altogether. The entire, I can say the entire summer season was completely wiped out. Everybody was prepared well during this year, March, April. But unfortunately, this thing happened, and initial lockdown, I think, wiped out the entire summer initiatives and summer range and all. But luckily, I can say, starting from the end of October, or the precisely, I can say, the November month, we have seen the very, very good response. There's a good customer response in the market. People are like, the fear was on the reducing trend, I can say. And we have seen a lot of customers are coming, they are buying, they are doing shopping. So that's a good trend we have witnessed. Especially what happened this year, the November, again, since it's a late Diwali we have seen, okay. And it's good coincide with the winter wear. So it's like, again, catering the basic need of the customer, which is like more of a seasonal of its kind, plus the festival need. I think combining both, the customers are there and they really purchase from us. And as a V-Mart, I can say the good part is that we were actually completely ready to cater the customer winter need. So irrespective of the Diwali season, there was good and huge mix of the winter wear also, because that was a precisely seasonal need of the customer, and they have to purchase it and to somewhere to fulfill their need and demand.
Right. So if you look at the kind of growth that you have seen, tell me what kind of products witnessed greater demand, and what was the contribution of non-markets in this recovery phase? Non-metro markets, I mean to say.
Okay. See, if we are talking, first of all, I'm coming to which all the products really were performed so good during this particular phase. I've already covered the winter wear. Winter wear means the winter jackets, the pullover, sweatshirt, etc. I think there we have seen the very good trend and upswing in the market. And number one. Number two, I think the kids wear, which, like, no matter whether it's a lockdown or not, kids are growing. Okay. So somewhere I think they have to purchase the new clothes. And that was in the very, very good trade. We have seen the new set of trade of the kids wear. That's another part. Second, third thing, I think the lot of work from home, the people are actually not moving out from the home. So their home, their daily wear kind of, actually, again, we have seen the very good trade there. So seasonal, kids wear, and the daily wear. These are the three big categories which actually we catered, and we rightly predicted, and I think we somehow fulfilled the demand of the customers. So that's the one part. If I'm talking the market, right, what your question was, like, it's like the major metro versus the tier 1, tier 2, and tier 3 and tier 4. So I think when you look at even the COVID cases number, it is look like a bigger story of the cities like Mumbai, Delhi, Calcutta, Bangalore. So there we have seen the very high numbers of the cases in comparison with, when I'm comparing the tier 2, tier 3 and tier 4, the numbers are pretty low. Okay. But luckily, I can say the V-Mart, our bigger business and the bigger purchases, like in the tier 2, tier 3 and tier 4 market. I still recall, like, when I visited in the November 2nd week, which was like again the peak week of the festival. Okay, at that point, at that point of time, I've seen the typically in the cities like Basti, Sultanpur. These are in the UP actually. Okay, Gorakhpur. So these cities, what I have seen, I think there was no fear of the COVID actually. So people are like, I think the markets are quite open. The people are moving here and there. The same kind of the good buzz was there. So maybe initial phase, irrespective of the low number of cases, but yes, since it was the big hype of the COVID and all these things, so people were not coming out from their market. But I think in the when I have seen the market, I think the people were very much there in the market. So I think the least impacted market is obviously the tier 4, then tier 3 and the tier 2. It's a more story of the problem and the concern is more about the major metro and the bigger malls.
Right. Just a follow-up question. So how would you assess the consumer sentiment in those non-metro areas?
See, non-metro areas, like it's largely an agri-driven kind of, okay? And luckily, I think I can say that this year, the agri is like really doing well. It's good. And there is no problem at all there. So I think that's a larger dependency. Number one. Number two, in these cities, again, the bigger set of consumption is unlike the major metro, I'm saying. In these kind of the market, the bigger set of consumption is coming during the wedding and the marriage season. So that also we have seen, like starting from post Diwali till 15th of December, we have seen the very good trend of the marriage season consumption here also.
Right. So tell me, if we look at the last 10 months, there has been a certain kind of behavioral shift as far as consumers are concerned. Do you think some have become permanent part of this customer journey, especially in the non-metro areas?
So obviously, there was a complete different picture was there, I think, good 3-4 months back. But when I'm looking at the certain things which will continue in the coming time also, maybe more relevant for the tier one, I can say, or maybe the major metros where the work from home actually increases. People learn, like, irrespective of without meeting the people, okay, one-to-one. I think you can interact with the good video call. So technology is really helping us. I think today also we are interacting digitally, not physically, right? So I think that's one trend big time emerging in the market. The new way of doing business, the new way of the interaction, the new way of the celebrations. I think people are using digital technology much more on the higher side. So far, the tier 2, tier 3 and tier 4, what I've seen even during the lockdown, even the post-lockdown also, I've seen a lot of people, they actually went to their hometowns. So largely when you see the working class people, more are from the tier 2 and tier 3 and tier 4, even in the major metros. So actually their consumption trend, what I've seen actually increased. So when I'm talking with the people, like, okay, so some people, they don't want to come back. We are very happy at our hometown now. So that's the one mindset created, what I've seen. I don't know whether it will sustain or not, but somehow I think the people are very, very happy at their hometowns, and there they are looking for the new set of the earning avenues, okay, in those markets. So I think over the time, we have seen the lot of urbanization actually happening, but I can say it's a reverse urbanization kind of with the COVID.
Mr. Jain, if you look, V-Mart has a very unique approach. It follows the concept of value retailing. Very, very few people do it. How has this proposition aided the brand this year, in your view?
So value retail, it's like always, I can say always bullies. I think we are catering to the real India, actually. We are not to only the 1 or 2% of the population. It's like larger set of customer. Our TG range is very, very large. When I'm talking the V-Mart per se or the value retail business per se, actually. What happened, we have seen the premium and the very, I think, this class of the brand. Okay. There we have seen the very, very high impact. But actually, the value retail is like catering your need. So COVID, the things which actually worked was your need, your basics. So these things actually worked during the COVID. And value retail is like catering your basic need. It's not the whether you have to purchase. There is no any choice. So for them, it's like sometimes it's like a commodity kind of thing. No matter whether it's a COVID or not, you have to eat. Okay. So it's like value retail is something, it's like catering to the basic need of the customer.
Right. So if we look at the demand curve for the next coming quarter in non-metros, how do you see it panning out?
So like what I've covered, like last year, what happened during the summer, okay? We have seen hardly people any purchased their needs. So what happened, I'm looking at it from the very big opportunity. It's like I myself have not purchased anything for the summer this time, but yes, for the winter wear, I purchased some stocks during the festival time. So I think somewhere the demand part, okay, is accumulating and now moving to the next year season. So when we will approach the summer season next year, so people wardrobe was like a older by 2 years kind of. So they purchased something in the year 2019. They have not purchased anything in the 2020. But yes, the 21, it is like 2 years accumulation happened. And I'm sure the trend will be like that.
Right.
Number one.
Right.
Number two, the bigger problem what is happening in the market, like there is a lot of disruption in the supply chain also, right, over the time. We have seen the payments problem in the market. We have seen the lot of manufacturing organization. They actually shut down. It's like disruption is there in the supply. So whoever is the player in the market, like who played good game, in good game means like somewhere able to either get the stocks on right time, I think they will get the better response. So this year actually winter also happened in same way. So we were like, I can say that we were better prepared, and hence what happened before Diwali itself, I think we placed our winter wear merchandise on the floor and we got the very good and phenomenal response from the customer. And the same idea is there. I think the next quarter, again, what we are trying that how we can cater our customer summer need, okay, which will anyway, I think in the demand, because I've told like it's a 2 years old wardrobe is there for the customer. So the idea is that how early we can cater the customer need, maybe mid of our Feb or the end of Feb, we should be ready for the customer. And Holi is the one very big festival, especially in our UP and Bihar. So that is also a good, very strong plan is there to cater that need. And Holi this year, again, the late Holi, it's like 27th of the March, end of March. So early Holi is like coincide with the, I can say slightly winter season, but 27th of March
it's
is like
new season altogether.
Summer, yeah. So customer will buy their need. So that's the hope we have.
Right. Very well said. Mr. June, tell me, 9 months, people have, brands especially, have got a lot of time to rethink, realign. And tell me, how has the market prioritization model changed for V-Mart over the last 10 months, if I may ask?
Market prioritization means you're talking from the geography point
focus,
of view?
Yes, geography and maybe product also.
Okay, obviously, see, the when we are talking the geography, I think obviously we are prioritizing more of the, I think I can say it's not only the prioritizing only here, it's like tier 2 and tier 3 and tier 4. Anyway, we are planning. So earlier the tier 4 market was on the comparatively on the lower side in terms of the mix of the business, but now we are looking for the good tier 4 opening also. So that's the one market prioritization I can say. Number two, I have already covered like the product which are of the basic need. Okay, the daily wear range of the customers. I think there we have to provide the good amount of stock, good new trends, new good festive stocks. I think that we will do. So that's a prioritization.
Right. So in our interaction with the marketeers, they've all said that non-metros were largely resilient markets. And if we look ahead from now on, what is the role that non-metro markets would play in the entire recovery process for brands?
Non-metro means you are talking the typical non-metro. So,
well, what will be their role in the recovery process of brands as we move on? How much of importance would those markets have as brands try to recover and get over what COVID has impacted them with?
So see, what happened, I'm looking modern retail from the 2 decades point of view. So modern retail, earlier it was the phenomena of the, it's largely a phenomena of cities like Delhi, Mumbai and major metros. Then it's moved to the tier 1, then it's moved to the tier 2. I think with the COVID, people learned that relying only on the bigger markets is not enough for them. Somewhere I think they have to enter and penetrate the tier 2, tier 3 and tier 4 market. So right. that will anyway, I think the emerging trend, and I'm sure that will happen. I just had right. the different conference attended for this particular part, like how important is the tier 2, tier 3 and tier 4 market, because that is a real India. That is a larger right. chunk of India. The bigger pie is there only. So right. I always call people like come and see this market. There's a huge potential and still to explore. So what we did for the bigger places, tier 1 and the major metro, 1.5 decade and one decade back, the same thing we have to do for now for the tier 2, tier 3 and tier 4 market.
So the vaccine is around, but we're still in the recovery phase. Tell me, Mr. Jain, what are the broad challenges that you foresee for V-Mart as we navigate this phase of recovery and then look at a phase that might bring back all the market the way it was before COVID? So what are the big challenges in this journey that you face, that you're facing?
You're talking about past or you're talking about the upcoming future?
Now, from now onwards, we are in the recovery phase. So what are the broad big challenges before you as we navigate this course and get into another side of it? As you said, March would be big. So what are the broad challenges before you right now?
I think I've already covered the one point, like there is a supply disruption. Okay. I think over the time, what we have seen, I think a lot of people actually went out from the market also. I'm talking from supply point of view. So that is the one challenge. Yes, we have to address that. And we are trying to address that. So this is the challenge I am looking for. Somewhere, this is the one part. Another part is like that with the COVID and the people starting working from home, not moving out, not going out from market. It's a part of the habit also of the customer. So I don't know how long this habit will be there. And third part, like even when we are talking the vaccine. So what I heard, maybe I am wrong also here, but what I heard, like the vaccine is not the permanent cure kind of thing. Even you are taking the vaccine again, it will work for the few months, maybe 6 months kind of. Again, you have to take it for the 6 months. So it's right. too early to comment on that particular part, what will happen after vaccine and all. But whether the vaccine right. will be there or not, what I have seen in the last 1.5 months, I think nobody can stop the human being to come out from their house area, at least in the India.
Absolutely. Two more questions. One is that in your view, what will be the big drivers of growth from V-Mart from here on from a strategy point of view? And what are the new markets that you're looking at reaching out now on? Are there more markets that you would look to target in the coming time? And which are those markets?
So I think when I'm talking from the market point of view, our presence is very strong in the UP and Bihar and Jharkhand right now. And yes, our presence is there in the eastern part, but I think the bigger penetration is still awaiting. So more and more, I think with the time, the idea is that still the UP market, the juice is not extracted fully. So there we have to somewhere augment the entire market, entire need. So there we are looking again, going the deeper penetration. So earlier we were catering like only tier 2, tier 3 largely. Now we are entering the tier 4 also in these Bihar, Jharkhand and UP market. But when I'm talking the eastern part, northeastern part, northeast part and Rajasthan, Gujarat, all these market, MP, I think there the market, our presence is not so large. So idea is that again in the coming 1 year, 2 years or 3 years time, how we can make ourselves large in these market also.
Right. My final question is, a lot of disruption has happened, the way consumers are there, the way technology is playing its role. So what is the future of retail going to be in your view? Like a little bit of, future vision into the future. How do you see that future of retail from here on, overall as an industry?
So one thing is that till the time human being will be there on the earth, I think there is no question on the basic thing, like which is like we are calling it a roti, kapda and makan. Okay, which is like precisely when I am talking in the retail thing, it's like retail language, okay, parlance. It is like food, fashion, and home. So that is always required. There is no any doubt. In future is very, very bright. And it's like, obviously, we have seen the trend of the unorganized to organized segment. And again, the last half decade precisely, I can say the lot of omni-channel online trade also enter into and pitch into our business. So I think the future, till the time human being is there, I think the need will be there and we are here to serve them. There is no doubt.
Very well said, Mr. Jain, and thank you so much for sharing your insights. It's been wonderful talking to you on this series presented by Dainik Bhaskar in association with Exchange for Media. Thank you again for your time.